Recording, perfect. So I speak a little bit of French. I did take a French class, which is random. So I was going to teach you guys a little bit of French today. I can see you and hear you. Oh, I see Alex. Hi.
No.
I'm so glad I'm not talking to myself. Okay, so I'm gonna teach you a little
unstable work
in France.
Okay. But I think my house. I think yours.
I need you to repeat after me. Learn how to say hello. All right, are you ready? All right, here we go. Say bonjour.
Yeah, hello.
Oh, okay. Let's try that again.
Bonjour.
Bonjour. That is hello. In bonjour is hello. It is spelled B-O-N-J-O-U-R. And it means hello. All right. I'm going to teach you another one. Be ready, okay? This one's a little bit harder. This is my name is. Okay. So to say my name is in French, you say je m'appelle. Nobody said it. Jem Appel.
Jem Appel.
Jem Appel is my name. So I would say, bonjour, je m'appelle Miss Clifton.
Bonjour. Bonjour.
Yeah, your name. That's right. So you just said, hello, my name is, and then your name. That's how you speak French. It's that easy, right? So,
bonjour.
Bonjour. And then your name. All right. So look at somebody and say, bonjour, je m'appelle, and your name. You're already speaking French. So I took two French classes when I was a lot younger, not recently. And I learned a lot of different things, but I only remember, hello, my name is, bonjour, je m'appelle Miss Clifton. I remember how to say, how are you today? Comment ça va? All right. And I remember how to say, I'm okay. Comme ci, comme ça. And I remember how to go to ask to go to the bathroom. So the phrase to go to the bathroom is, puis-je aller à WC, s'il vous plaît? So I don't remember that, but I remember how to say my name and how are you and where's the bathroom? So I guess those are important things to remember, right? Your name and how are you and where do I find the bathroom? So I just thought that was funny. But congratulations, you are now speaking French because now you can say bonjour. My name is Je m'appelle, and then your name. I love it. See, you've already learned something today. So we are going to be spending a lot of time in France today. But before we get on our plane and fly over across the sea to France, we need to get a little active. So I need everybody to stand up. All right. So this is not French, but it is one of my favorite starters for my classroom that we do a lot. And this is Alive, Alert, Awake, and I'm going to do it with you. All right. And it gets faster and faster. So pay attention. Okay. Here we go.
Here we go. Engine takeoff.
I'm faster.
I'm all even faster. A little bit faster. As fast as you can.
I'm feeling so awake right now.
Just kidding. Bobby is always awake.
Okay, that was my fringe. But that is one of my favorite get starters in my classroom. Y'all can have a seat. So I suggest y'all save that one. It's really quick, but it's super fun. And so I'm alive, alert, awake, enthusiastic, right? What a great way to start the day. You're alive, alert, awake, and you have enthusiasm, meaning you're excited. So are you excited to go to France with me? Yeah? Okay. Well, we are going to hop on our imaginary plane, and we are going to fly across the sea to France, and we are going to go to the most famous city in France. Who can tell me the most famous city? Oh, Alexander City Kindergarten. Can y'all tell me? I see hands up. What's the most famous city in France? Yes. How many of y'all have seen the movie, the Disney movie Ratatouille? Yeah. So in Ratatouille, he goes to Paris. That's where he wants to go cook because it's very famous for having great food and having lots of culture. And so we're going to visit some of the buildings there today. So can somebody tell me any of the buildings that are famous in Paris? I know y'all talked about one on Monday. What's a famous building or structure?
The Eiffel Tower.
Eiffel Tower. Good job, Pine Glen. All right. Does anybody else know any other ones? There's several. Somebody else want to try? Let's see. We got the Eiffel Tower. Does anybody else know another one?
Right. What are you saying? The Leaning Tower. The Leaning Tower. It's on mute. It's on mute. That's on
mute. All right. I think I heard the Notre Dame Cathedral.
In the Big Ben.
What else?
Big Ben.
Big Ben. That's in London. All right. What else? Alexander City Kindergarten. Y'all want to try one? No? Okay. Well, I'm going to show y'all some really quick, okay? So there's lots of famous buildings there. The three most famous that I know of are the Arch de Triomphe, which is like this big arch thing that people drive, that you actually drive through. It's on a roundabout. And cars drive through it. And then you have the Notre Dame Cathedral, which is super famous, and it like caught on fire. There's like a whole like movie about where it caught on fire and it like caused all this panic in the city, and but they rebuilt it. And then there's of course the Eiffel Tower. So let me screen share and show you some of these really quick. Y'all don't forget about Alive, Alert, and Awake. That's a fun one. All right. So here we go. So I wanted y'all to see some of these buildings. This is not what I thought I had pulled up. Just kidding. All right, let's see. Maybe it's right. Yeah, right here. Okay. All right, let's see if it'll show you some. There's. Okay, so here we go. So this one right here in the middle that's got the sunset, that's, excuse me, that's the Notre Dame Cathedral. So it's super famous. And then, of course, y'all already knew the Eiffel Tower. And then I was going to show you, I thought I had one of the Arch de Triomphe, but I might not. I don't. Yes, I do. Okay. Well, anyways, but France pretty much kind of looks like Alabama. Like the weather's kind of similar to what we have here. So it's not that different, but it does have some really old famous buildings. Also, on this one, I know I taught you a few French things, but this one is. It's also got some other French words on there if you wanted to say something else that I did not already teach you. So, okay. All right. Let me close that and stop sharing. All right. So, our story today is called Paris Up, Up, and Away. And I'm going to read it to you. Y'all know I love some Disney movies. And so, when I think about France, I think about Ratatouille. But when I think about this book, I think about Up. All right. And the Disney movie Up. What does Mr. Fredrickson put on his house that makes his house lift? Do y'all know? Do y'all remember? What's he put on his house to make it
Balloons!
lift? Yes. So in this story that we're going to read today, the Eiffel Tower goes on a trip with some balloons, right? And so I was like, oh, it's like a combination of two of my favorite Disney movies, Ratatouille and Up. Y'all, hang on. I'm going to get a sip of water. Have any of y'all been outside? It feels cooler today than what it has been, but whew, it's been a little hot. So, anyway, all right, so let me screen share and I'm going to read us our story. This is called Paris Up, Up, and Away. And I'm going to mute her and I'm going to read it to you. So, this lady that does the read aloud, if you go back and watch the video, she does a lot better French accent than I do, but that is okay. Oh, we got an ad. I've been getting lots of ads lately. All right, here we go. Right, so this book is by Helene Drouvert, and she is a French author. And you can already see from the picture, there's the Eiffel Tower. And then there's those balloons that are going to carry it away. And this book is unique because it's a cutout book. And so as we go through the pages, you'll see all the different pictures of the cutouts. Paris, up, up, and away. All right. And it says to Michael, thanks for all of our Vespa rides through Paris. All right. The Eiffel Tower is bored today. Wouldn't it be nice to fly away? Paris is full of things to do. The tower would like to see them too. So the tower takes off for the day to watch the city work and play. And you can see the balloons attached to the tower and it's lifted up and started floating. And then I'm going to show you as she turns the page. This is a cutout book. So the page, when it turns, it's kind of open so you can still see parts of it, which is kind of cool. You can see a little family painting at the bottom. All right. And so as the Eiffel Tower is floating by, I love this picture because this little girl is looking at it and she lets go of her balloon because the Eiffel Tower is attached to all these balloons floating by. And it kind of makes me think of that movie Up. I bet people just stopped and stared as the house floated by because it's not something they're used to seeing. All right, so here's our first major stop. The tower looks down from the sky and sees the river Seine roll by, which is a very famous river that runs through the heart of France. And you see the people on the bridge and the guy playing the accordion. And there's all the people by the light post, and there's even a dog over here on the ground. The Eiffel Tower passes by the bridges and boats below, but the clouds are turning dark in the sky. Oh, rain starts falling from the sky. The tower looks for somewhere dry. So now the tower's going to the metro station, which is kind of like a busy area, like a subway area, which we don't really have in Alabama, but if you think of like a big city where all the taxis and things park, it's kind of like that. Umbrellas help keep off the rain, but Paris looks pretty all the same, just the same. So there's the people in their umbrellas, and you can kind of see the Paris skyline and all the famous buildings. All right, so our first stop is the Opera House. We made the opera house when we visited Sydney, but they have a famous opera house in Paris too. And it says the opera is the tower's next stop where ballerinas twirl and hop. And you can see this one's made very different. It's very traditional looking, not like the one that we did in Sydney, Australia. The tower shrinks down small and neat to walk with people on the street. It visits a big department store with lovely things on every floor. So this is not like a department store when I think of one. I think of like JCPenney's or Sears. But this one has escalators, and all different things on each floor. And looks like it has lots of fancy things. The sun comes out and the sky is clear. So the tower lands in a park that's near. And you can see what's happening in the park with the carousel and the people. I love it. And the girl jumping rope. While the children play and the birds fly free, the tower snoozes under a tree. In other words, it takes a little nap. You see all the little characters she's showing you with the cutout pages. And more balloons. The tower wakes up. Is someone calling? And here is that famous cathedral I was telling you about, the Notre Dame. It's the Notre Dame. Bells say that night is falling. So this cathedral is really famous. And I normally read a book to my students called The Man Who Walked Between the Towers. And it was about a French man named Philippe Petit. And he actually did a tightrope walk between these two towers at the Notre Dame Cathedral first before he came to the United States. And he walked between the Twin Towers before they fell. And so I like to read that book to my students on September 11th. But it's a little bit of a French connection to the U.S. Oh, the tower switches on its lights and shines them all over the city sights. So many beautiful things to see in Paris. Yeah. Just showing you all the people. All right, and there's the lights. All right, and then it shows you all the different famous places in downtown France. And so this is that arch I was telling you about over here in the corner. She just pointed to it. And then there's the shopping mall we went to, the opera hall. And then down here underneath her hand is the cathedral. She'll slide down right there. So there's lots and I mean, the Parthenon, there's so many different things to see in France. But we're going to focus on these buildings today. So I wanted to share that story with you. Like I said, it's a very unique book. It shows you lots of different It shows you lots of different places in France. Now, we are going to do a quick little video about visiting France, and then we're going to get to our build. But before we do that, here's what I need us to do. So you've got to decide what building you want to build. There's three choices. You can build the Arch de Triomphe today. Can't spell. Or you can build the... I put an E on the end, but I didn't need to. The Eiffel Tower. Or you can build the Notre Dame Cathedral. However, It's got to stand up. So think about when you're building this, because all we're going to be using is paper and tape. So I have like just clear some clear tape and scissors. And then I have all of these. I'm going to use orange paper because I have a lot of it. So I'm going to use all of these pieces of paper. And I'm actually going to make a 3D building stand out of paper. So that is the tricky part today. It's not just a flat picture. We're going to make it actually stand up. So let me screen share and give you an idea of what I'm looking for. And then you can decide which one you want to build, because whichever one you build depends, your style depends on that. So this one is the Eiffel Tower. They made theirs out of newspaper. But do y'all see what I mean? But it's literally going to have to stand up. And you're going to have to work as a team to do this. This can't just be a one-person job. All right? So if you do the Eiffel Tower, rolling the paper looks like it works. So that might be easier, just an idea, than you building a square building. But that's your choice, okay? So the Notre Dame Cathedral is going to be very square, okay? And then the Arch de Triomphe is also going to be very square, but it's got a rounded middle. So that one might be the hardest. So be thinking about the groups you're going to work with and which one of these you want to build, okay? Be thinking about that as we watch this video, okay? Be planning in your head which one you're going to do. All right.
This morning, we're going to take a tour with Experience First. They're going to take us up the stairs to the first level, where they're going to tell us all about the history of the Eiffel Tower and how it was built. And then we get to go all the way to the top. The Eiffel Tower was built by Gustav Eiffel in 1889. More on
him later. It's really much better. The Eiffel Tower took 2 years, 2 months, and 5 days to complete. It's built completely new iron. This was shipped here from Armenia. It was originally built for the Eiffel Tower, but Gustav Eiffel wanted to keep it up for longer. The people of Paris liked the Eiffel Tower. They thought it was ugly. But Gustav Eiffel convinced the city to keep it in his name for 20 years.
The original name of the Eiffel Tower was the Iron Tower. You can see the nets and scaffolding all around the tower. That's because they're actually painting the tower right now, as they do one time every 7 years.
The Eiffel Tower is undergoing the 2018 campaign. In order to do that, they have to spin out the thing that used to be in it. The Eiffel Tower is increasing the traditional women rest in place. 25 things that come together to see the entire Eiffel Tower. Great. Yeah, and then they feel that they come off.
You're about to go up the stairs and climb to the second story of the Eiffel Tower.
You can see that now that there is the Eiffel Tower. Every 7 years, they rename the tower. The first color that the Eiffel Tower ever was red.
Okay, we're having our first step from the Eiffel Tower right now.
Okay, we're
at 328 steps to the first floor of Tower 1.
Oh, I was just yeah. And there's a way to the different hall. I the vertical and the 10 minutes to the first step. You can see how there's names of chips and paint that I painted in the floor. The Eiffel Tower was built in the wrong thing. It's built on exhibition. In 1889.
The Eiffel Tower was built. There was no elevator. People had to climb down the stories and steps. And not the nice stuff through the top step.
So, Gustav Eiffel paid to keep the Eiffel Tower in business for the first 20 years.
After that, the city of Paris saw that it was valuable and decided to keep it with his name on it. Now we're going to take another 300 steps up to the second floor, where we will get on an elevator that's going to take us all the way to the top.
Could y'all imagine going this high up? I mean, and then having to do it in stairs and not an elevator?
If the name Gustav Eiffel sounds familiar, it may be because you heard about him in another video going inside the Statue of Liberty. Gustav Eiffel helped design the Statue of Liberty and put it to America as a gift. He lived here in Paris and he built the Eiffel Tower as well. That's why the Eiffel Tower is called the Eiffel Tower. I actually like the view of the bar, but it was pretty. We're staying at the tallest point you can get to on the Eiffel Tower. Right above it, and I'm looking at it right now, is the antenna, which is 1,064 feet off the ground.
Okay, pause. So there is a good picture of the arch that I was talking about that you could also build if you wanted to do like a square structure. But you see, like, cars actually drive through this thing. It's pretty cool.
One of the main reasons I was not too sad in 1909, supposed to be, was they put a weather station on top for monitoring the weather. Since at the time it was the tallest structure in the world, they could get very accurate radar and other information from the top of the tower.
The mannequins are showing today when Thomas Edison gave Gustav Eiffel his first show.
Okay, so now I feel like we've really been to France. Stop my share. Okay, so that was a really fun trip, and I'm glad you actually got to see the Arch de Triomphe, too. So now you've seen the Notre Dame Cathedral, the Arch de Triomphe, and the Eiffel Tower. So those are your three choices to build. And remember, this is an actual standing structure. So let's talk about our build, all right? I'm going to unblur my background so y'all can see my plan. Okay, so I drew a picture of what I think all three of these would look like. Now, I've got to decide which one I'm going to build. But the Eiffel Tower, I think I'm going to roll my paper into tubes to make it. All right. But if I do the Notre Dame Cathedral, I'm going to have to fold my paper into blocks. And if I do this arch, I think I'm going to have to do a little bit of rolling and folding. Okay. So those are my plans, because all good engineers always start with a plan. So I've planned my build. I know what I'm going to build. So let's talk about what it has to have. I'm going to put this in the chat box. It has to be freestanding, okay? Freestanding means like you and me, okay? I don't have to have anything to hold me up. I can stand on my own 2 feet and not fall over, all right? This is what I mean by freestanding, okay? Standing up, all right? So it has to be freestanding. It can't be leaning on something or holding something up or taped. It's got to stand by itself, all right? The only things that you can use are paper, tape, and scissors. So I really think this is going to be where you're going to have to work together and different people are doing different parts. Like somebody's rolling the paper, somebody's taping it, somebody's putting it together. This really needs to be a group work activity. I hope y'all are listening to Miss Clifton. It really needs to be a group work activity. Okay. The last thing is you got to decide which one you're going to build. So I'm going to let y'all help me vote. Okay. I'm going to put a poll up and I'm going to let y'all help me vote which one I build for you. Okay. Because I don't mind building any of these. I will gladly build any of them, but I want you to help me decide which one I need to build. I thought that. Okay. There we go. All right. So let me find my little poll. Stop it. I thought I could do a poll. Y'all know what? Sometimes, there it is. There it is. Okay. All right. So I'm going to give y'all a poll. Which should I build? All right. Should I build the Eiffel Tower? Should I build the Notre Dame Cathedral? Or should I build the Arch? Okay. So I think I shared it. Did I not share it? There we go. All right, so it's up. I need y'all to vote really quickly. Which one should I build? Oh, I've got two people that have voted so far. Oh, three voted so far. Oh, four. Six, waiting on one more vote. Okay, well, we're going to end it there. So the winner was, 5 out of 6 voted for the Eiffel Tower. So I guess I am building the Eiffel Tower. All right, so that tells me the first thing I need to do is I need to get to rolling some paper. So I'm going to flip my camera around so I have some workspace and I'll be standing. And I'm going to start rolling my paper into rolls to build the Eiffel Tower. All right. There we go. All right, so I'm going to start by making those long, I'm going to make 4 of those long tubes to be the 4 pieces that are standing. Okay, that's where I'm going to start. So 4 long tubes. All right, so I've gotten one. Now, I wish I had my masking tape here. I don't have it here. And the clear tape does not work as good as I need it to. Let me see if I had it. I thought I had another tape somewhere. Oh, well. Okay. But that's all right. I'm going to try to make this clear tape work. All right, so here goes another one. Let's see, I might have some duct tape. I need something better. There we go. Better than clear tape. A little more stronger. Y'all know I love masking tape. We call it paper tape at school. It is my preferred, but I don't happen to have that here at the house. And they are waxing my classroom right now, so I can't even get into my room at the school. Because I was going to do this with newspaper for you guys, but my newspapers are at the school. Okay, we're just plan B. That's what we do. Roll with whatever. Okay, much better. I'm going to cut me off some pieces of this tape. I love that Alexander City Kindergarten's building as I'm building, and Pine Glen, I can see you building as I'm building. Look at y'all. I love it when you're working, when I'm working. I wish I had a partner here with me. That'd be great. All right, I got two made. Got two more to go. And then I still got to make the middle part. All right, got three. I got to make one more. And so far, I've not used any scissors. All I've used is paper and tape. I need some more pieces of tape to have over here on the side. Okay, so now I'm gonna try to make that triangle shape with these four tubes by sticking them together. I don't know if this is gonna work well. We're gonna try it and see. I build with you guys in real time. So like I don't pre-build anything, so it may or may not work. We're gonna try it and see. Like I said, this is where if I had a partner here with me, that would have been fantastic, but that's okay. I'm gonna see if I can do this by myself. Because remember, the goal is that it's gonna stand up without me holding it. Gotta be free standing. So there's one. All right, and then I need to connect these two. And somehow get these together to make it stand on all four. Oh, look at that. So I rolled the four tubes. Let me see if I can turn this up. And I've got it taped together up here at the top so it will stand without me holding it. But this doesn't really look like the Eiffel Tower. I've got to add some more decorative pieces to it. But step one, it does stand. So the Eiffel Tower has this triangle shape at the top. I think I'm going to cut some paper to make a triangle shape. And it also has like a support level right here, but I think I'm going to cut. So I think I'm going to use this last piece of orange paper and cut and make my triangle and my support. Okay, so I rolled paper to do like a cone shape for the top. Okay, and then we'll tape it. Okay. Definitely have used lots of tape. So I've got my cone shape for the top and it's still standing by itself. It's not taped to the table or anything, like I can pick it up. So it is freestanding, but it doesn't really look Eiffel Tower-ish. I think I'm gonna add some supports right here in this area to kind of make it look like the tower shape. So more paper rolling. Lots of scissors, lots of tape, and lots of paper today. Okay, so I've made four supports, and I'm going to put them around the bottom, kind of make it more tower-looking. And it looks like I need four more pieces of tape, at least. So. All right, I'm going to try to add these supports and see if I can have a standing Eiffel Tower. Looks like I need a little bit more tape. Okay. All right. I'm going to say that I am done with my freestanding Eiffel Tower. I'm gonna try to pull up a picture of the real Eiffel Tower and see how I did in comparison with my paper freestanding version. I hope that you guys are building yours. I can't wait to see what yours looks like. Mine's all orange because, well, that's what I have. Because I couldn't get in my classroom and get my other paper. So orange is what I had here. So orange is what we rolled with, right? And then it's silver for duct tape, which I don't really like to use. I prefer masking tape, but like I said, I couldn't get in my ring, so it's okay. We just plan A, B, C, D, E, F, G, right? Okay. So, let me see if I can find a picture of the real thing, and we'll see how this compares. Now, it is pretty tall. I don't know if y'all can see. I know you can't see the top of it from the way my camera is, but it's pretty tall. It's a good bit taller than me. Let me see if I find the picture. Oh, it looks like it needs more levels, I think. Let me see. Okay, so I'm looking at the picture and I definitely need to add a bottom level to mine. So I'm going to make some changes and I'm going to add a little bit more. So that's one thing that you'll learn as you're engineering things is sometimes you don't have everything you think you need. So I'm going to add some more to this, even though I thought I was done. Let me see if I can share this picture with y'all so y'all can see what I mean, where I need to add more. attach from my computer. Eiffel Tower, where is it? There it is. Okay, so you can see in this picture, I put it in the chat box. There's another level that's like right here. So I'm going to add another level. Okay, see, I thought I was done, but I'm done. All right, so let me get my scissors and tape back out. Because I need to add another level. It doesn't look quite right. So there's my scissors. I'm like, look at my scissors vanish. Okay. I told my husband, you know your wife's a painter when you have construction paper and tape and all the things at the house, too. You just never know. All right, so building a structure, freestanding, where it's not, nothing's holding it up, preferably like one of the buildings in France that we talked about. And we voted, and everybody voted for me to do the Eiffel Tower. Well, not everybody. It was like 6-1 for the Eiffel Tower. So that's what I'm building. We're trying to get there. Oh, I see Alex in kindergarten. Y'all are working hard. I'm almost afraid that if I add a lot more to this, that I'm going to mess it up too, to be honest, because I want it to be able to stand by itself, and then the more I add, the heavier it gets. But we shall see. Wonder if I just add a piece of paper to be that level, like if I can fold it down so it'll fit in the sides, maybe? Okay. I think I'm going to call it done there. I really wanted to add a level like this one here, but I can't get it to fit with my support. So I'm just kind of adding the best I can. All right, so let's see what we got. If I can get this where y'all can see it, the whole thing in the camera. Let's see. Woo! And my top's kind of turning over. But you can see I have a freestanding, I'm not touching it, tower that kind of looks like the Eiffel Tower. I mean, it's Eiffel Tower-ish, all right? My cone at the top needs a little work. I probably should have made it a little wider, but that, you know what? That's engineering for you. So this is my final product, all right? And so now that you've seen mine, I'm going to flip back around because I want to see what you have. And if you're not finished, that's okay. You just show me what you have so far, okay? Let me flip back around. Okay. Now I'm seated again. So I did the best I could to make a freestanding Eiffel Tower. I do think that the rolled paper was a great idea. The cone needs a little love. I'm just gonna be honest at the top. But otherwise, it did stand by itself and I did add those two layers. Hey, very cool. All right, so I'm gonna spotlight. It looks like Alexander City Kindergarten is ready. All right, so let me spotlight. Hey, there you go. All right, hold it up. Hold it up so we can see it.
So, okay, we have some extra materials that we were just reusing, and so it's marshmallows and noodles.
Perfect.
That they made apple pie with.
And it makes a perfect cake, too. Y'all, that's so good. That pyramid. Awesome.
I ate mine. Me too.
Let me get that.
They ate theirs.
I'm gonna eat mine.
Hey, great use of materials that you had too. I am always a big fan of that. So y'all will hear me say throughout, like, if you don't have this, it's fine. And I really do try to keep mine where you don't need a lot of stuff. But that was a great idea. I've never thought about the spaghetti and marshmallows, but that's perfect. Hey, okay, Lily Baptist, I'm going to spotlight you. There it goes. Okay, look at that. So they used Unifix cubes and construction paper. I love it. I love that you use the cubes for the base and it stands by itself.
Thank you.
Thank you. So we already had two designs that used two different things, and they both were fantastic. Did y'all see that? We had spaghetti and marshmallows. We had Unifix cubes and construction paper. Anybody else have something different? Pine Glen, I see y'all. Y'all are like me. We were struggling with them paper rolls. Mm-hmm. I see it, but that's okay. I got it to somewhat stick together. Anybody else want to share? Anybody else get a build done? If you're still building this, okay. So if you get on this afternoon, I'll be back on at 1. If you get on this afternoon, since I did the Eiffel Tower this morning, I'll probably do one of the other buildings this afternoon at 1, probably the cathedral or the arch. So, but it'll be the same book and everything. But I'm going to do a different building so that I'll have an example of both. And I'll send y'all pictures. The other thing I want to talk about is tomorrow is kind of my favorite. Okay, I'm not going to lie. Tomorrow is about the Tour de France, which is the bike race that happens in France every year. It's like this huge deal. But tomorrow you get to design. It's just a printable. All right, so you just print out the paper t-shirt. but you get to design your own jersey for the Tour de France. And there's a video that talks about like how they wear like bright colors and how they have like different sponsors and numbers and stuff on them. So like I said, tomorrow's kind of my favorite. So y'all get to do the Tour de France jersey design tomorrow. And it's, like I said, it's a big bicycling race. By the way, before we leave today, did anybody hear what other famous thing we have in the U.S. that was helped make by Gustav Eiffel? All right, Gustav Eiffel helped build this really famous thing we have here in the United States. Do y'all remember what it was? Did y'all hear? I put you on the spot. Y'all didn't know there was going to be a quiz. Okay, well, I'm going to tell you. Gustav Eiffel helped make the Statue of Liberty. And so the Statue of Liberty that we kind of talked about, well, we didn't have Zoom last week, but on the 4th of July, that we kind of talk about when we celebrate the United States' birthday, was a gift from France. And Gustav Eiffel helped design that. So I thought that was really cool. So it's like we have a little connection between what we made today and what we celebrated last week. Hey, Bama kids, I see your note that you'll present at 1, and that's perfect. So like I said, I'll be back on at 1, and like I said, I'll probably build one of the other buildings. You guys did amazing today. I love it when y'all share different ways to do things too. So please don't ever be afraid to do that. I will see you guys next week. Next week, we're going to Japan. Next week, we're going to Japan, and we're making a paper version of one of my favorite things to eat. So I might have to make the real thing too. That's all I'm going to say. Okay. All right. So have fun with this. I'll be back on at 1. And y'all know I love you. You are amazing. My favorite. I can't wait to see you again. All my love.